Over the last month, extraordinary advances in paleontology and archaeology have greatly aided our knowledge of history. From uncovering the dietary habits of ancient hunter-gatherers to the intricate social behaviors of Neanderthals, and even finding the world's oldest known burial site so far. Here are the most incredible archaeological discoveries of June 2024. For decades, experts assumed that pre-archaeological human populations depended largely on animal protein, but new information is proving this theory wrong. The Neolithic Revolution, which occurred around 11,000 years ago, marked humanity's transition from hunting and gathering to farming, significantly impacting human nutrition. Historically, most research on pre-agricultural nutrition has concentrated on European and Asian Paleolithic sites. As a result, data from these places informed much of our knowledge of diets throughout this period. The inadequate preservation of items in dry areas, such as North Africa, has further hampered our understanding of food behaviors there. A PhD candidate researching this issue in Morocco as part of a research team is helping us understand the Stone Age diet a bit further. One of the most important advances in this study was the analysis of chemical residues in fossils. This approach, known as isotopic analysis, looks at microscopic chemical signatures of food preserved in bones and teeth. Since the 1970s, stable isotope analysis has been used to explore ancient diets and lifestyles by examining collagen protein in bones. For example, carbon isotope analysis has been used to determine maize intake in ancient Northern American cultures. The researchers examined the bones and teeth of early Homo sapiens buried at Tafarolt Cave, which is located in northern Morocco. The site, which is regarded as one of North Africa's oldest cemeteries, includes some of Africa's oldest human DNA. These graves are related to the Ibero-Mauritian civilization, dating back between 15,100 and 13,900 years. The site has been intensively investigated, yielding important information on the Paleolithic epoch in northwest Africa. The investigation found that, although the Ibero-Mauritians ate some meat, their diet was mostly plant-based. The isotopic profiles of the teeth and bones revealed a strong dependence on wild flora, with no indication of marine or freshwater food intake, despite the site's closeness to water sources. The data also showed that young children were exposed to solid meals at an early age, most commonly in the form of plant-based porridge or soup. The study also revealed why the Tafarolt people had a high rate of dental cavities. The intake of starchy plant foods, along with a lack of dental care, certainly contributed to tooth decay. This research shows how late Stone Age hunter-gatherers in North Africa relied more on plant-based diet than we previously thought, eating mostly vegetation thousands of years before agriculture arose. Another groundbreaking discovery revealed the compassionate nature of Neanderthals, showing that they were capable of providing benevolent care to vulnerable members of their social groupings. A pioneering study conducted by an international team of academics, including those from Binghamton University and the State University of New York, discovered the first instance of Down syndrome among Neanderthals. The study, led by anthropologists from University of Acala and the University of Valencia in Spain, focuses on the skeletal remains of a Neanderthal kid found at Cova Negra, a notable archaeological site in Valencia, Spain. The infant, dubbed Tina, was researched using cutting-edge procedures such as microcomputed tomography scans, which enabled the production of a comprehensive three-dimensional model of a skull piece that included the ear area. Tina's remains showed indications of a congenital inner ear disorder linked to Down syndrome, which causes significant hearing loss and vertigo. Despite her severe handicap, Tina lived until at least the age of 6, indicating that she got substantial care from her Neanderthal tribe. This result is noteworthy because it shows that Neanderthals were not only capable of caring for people with impairments, but extended that care to those who were unable to reciprocate, suggesting real altruism. But what does the discovery of a Neanderthal with Down syndrome tell us about their social behavior? The discoveries at Cova Negra has helped us comprehend Neanderthal life along the Mediterranean coast of the Iberian Peninsula. According to Professor Valentin Villaverde of the University of Valencia, These findings provide information on the transient and small-scale character of Neanderthal communities. Researchers have known that Neanderthals cared for disabled individuals, but this discovery is the first indication of care extended to a child with substantial problems. Previous reports on social care among Neanderthals included adults, prompting some to contend that such care should be viewed as reciprocal rather than altruistic. Tina's story contradicts this idea by demonstrating that Neanderthals cared for people who are unable to reciprocate, hence confirming the presence of true altruism among Neanderthal groups. Mercedes Conde, professor at the University of Akala and primary author of research, noted that Tina's findings not only sheds insight on Neanderthals' social dynamics, but also demonstrates their ability to engage in sophisticated social activities. Are you interested in the most recent findings in human evolution? Press that subscribe button for weekly updates and support our growing channel. This next discovery is questioning our understanding of ancient human behavior. Paleontologists in South Africa have discovered the world's earliest known burial site, showcasing the bones of Homo naledi, a hominid with a tiny brain that was previously considered incapable of sophisticated behavior. The discoveries, which were released in 2023, were headed by renowned paleoanthropologist Lee Berger and his colleagues. The site is situated around 30 meters below in a cave system inside the Cradle of Humankind, a UNESCO World Heritage Site near Johannesburg. The recently found burial site predates the earliest known Homo sapien graves by at least 100,000 years. This noteworthy result calls into question the traditional theory of human evolution, which holds that sophisticated behaviors like burial ceremonies were only seen in animals with bigger brains, such as Homo sapiens. The previously oldest graves, discovered in the Middle East and Africa, were related to Homo sapiens and dated back around 100,000 years. In contrast, Homo naledi graves date from at least 200,000 BCE. This finding shows that Homo naledi, a primate with a brain the size of an orange and a height of around 1.5 meters, participated in elaborate funeral customs. So how did Homo naledi create the oldest known burial site? Recent digs, which started in 2018, discovered oval-shaped interments. Evidence reveals that these holes were purposefully excavated and filled to conceal the corpses of at least five people. Berger's results, which have previously sparked debate in the area of paleontology, challenges the concept that brain size alone affects cognitive and emotional capacities. Berger's prior declaration in 2015 that Homo naledi may exhibit more sophisticated behaviors than its brain size indicated was regarded with skepticism. However, recent results back up his theory. The consequences of these discoveries are substantial. They propose that burial, symbolic activities, and potentially even art may have a more complicated and non-human origin than previously considered. Carol Ward, an anthropologist at the University of Missouri, who was not involved in the study, also recognized the potential significance of the results, argues that more research is required to ensure that subsequent hominids did not create the marks. Shifting from burial practices to genetics, another recent study is exploring an intriguing question. How does Neanderthal DNA affect autism spectral disorder? The study conducted by researchers at Clemson University and Loyola University New Orleans suggests a potential link between Neanderthal DNA and autism spectral disorder. The team analyzed DNA from 3,442 people of diverse ethnic backgrounds using data from databases like the Simmons Foundation Powering Autism Research, Genotype Tissue Expression, and 1,000 genomes. They identified 25 Neanderthal-derived polymorphisms associated with brain development that were more prevalent in autistic individuals. Although the overall amount of Neanderthal DNA did not differ significantly between those with and without autism, significant genetic markers, such as a variation in the SLC37A1 gene linked to epilepsy, were found to be more common among autistic individuals with epilepsy. The research indicates that certain Neanderthal-derived genetic variants are more common in individuals with autism compared to the general population, highlighting the long-term effects of ancient human hybridization on brain organization and function. But the study also emphasizes that not everyone with these Neanderthal-derived variants will develop autism, Instead, these genetic traits may contribute to a higher susceptibility to autism, among other complex traits. The research aims to improve early diagnostics by better understanding these genetic influences. Fascinated by the most recent updates as of June 2024? Remember to subscribe and check out our other videos on human evolution, and join us in discovering more primitive secrets.